Buzzard, and today I am going to be showing you guys everything that you guys see in this entire YouTube shot or this entire office space. This is actually just my office or my editing space. This is where I actually conduct all my business. I do all of my daily office work, my invoicing, my editing, my, you know, daily planning, my scheduling, everything that I do for business and work, I do down here in this office. Recently, I've actually adapted this space to be a little bit more friendly for creating my own content for myself. I wanted to be able to quickly turn around in my desk and be able to film YouTube videos and content for you guys. So I've had to pretty much just adapt what I already had going on in this extremely small corner basement office setup so that I could have it look somewhat presentable for YouTube and for you guys. This space is extremely versatile, whether I'm looking to do just my normal office work, invoicing, planning, whatever it may be, or whether I'm looking to do production work, or I'm looking to shoot photos of people or products, or I'm looking to film a YouTube video. So I've kind of adapted this space to be extremely versatile and to be used as a multi-use space. That way I can do anything that I need to be able to do down here. And this space isn't feeling like it's hindering me from doing whatever creative work that I'm looking to do. So starting off with the desks are actually extremely, extremely budget desks that I found on Amazon. At the time I bought them, this desk behind me was about $160, and this desk right here was about $90. However, now you can get this big desk back here for $100, $99.99 as of today when I checked, and you can get this smaller desk in front for only $39.99. So for under $150, you can get two phenomenal work surfaces that are extremely durable. I feel like all my equipment and even both my monitors, everything that I have on top of it, these have plenty of stability and strength to them to be able to hold everything that I want them to hold. And I've even sat on them and stuff like that, and I've never had any issues, heard any creaks or anything that you shouldn't be hearing. So even though these desks are extremely budget, they are extremely well-made desks. The desk behind me is a 63-inch D-Lind Home desk. I'll link to it down in the description down below. And this one in front is a 39-inch desk. I went with a smaller desk in front. That way I just had room to walk around and stuff like that. But this desk in front I've used for product photography and just filming quick stuff for these YouTube videos, such as B-roll and stuff like that. But they're just phenomenal surfaces and are extremely versatile. And that actually brings us to the backdrop, which is one thing that I'm always getting asked about. And I'm actually pretty proud of this backdrop behind me. The backdrop itself is just a custom made 11x8 frame. And then on top of the frame, I actually put some of this tongue and groove style wood. I just kind of found it over at the hardware store. I'm not a woodworker or anything like that. I basically cut a whole bunch of them in half, and then I use those on the sides. And then I kind of alternated those with the full length ones to kind of get this little bit of a pattern to the actual wood that was being laid down on that backdrop. And then I did plan on actually finishing it with either a stain or some type of paint. I just haven't decided what I want to finish it in yet. And I've been liking the natural wood look with just the color, with the lighting coming down on it. So I haven't done anything as far as finishing to it yet, but I definitely want to finish it in some way in the future. I just haven't committed to exactly how I want to finish it. Now, on top of this backdrop, you guys can't see it in this shot, but on top of the backdrop, I have just a very inexpensive, newer backdrop holder, and that holds a single backdrop, and it has a nice little pole on there that allows me to raise it up and down whenever I need it or want to put it away. Right now, I just have a simple white backdrop on there. I can use it, I can splash some color on that white backdrop and really make it pop and, you know, change the look of that white backdrop just by adding some color of some sort using a light. Moving on from the backdrop, let's actually talk about one thing that I get asked about all the time, and that's my lighting setup for the basement or for my home office setup. Now, down here in the home office, I have a very, very simple lighting setup. The lights, the colored lights that you guys actually see behind me, all of these lights are made by a company called Singled. You can get these lights at Best Buy. You can get them at Amazon. But they are very, very inexpensive. Basically, Philips Hue copies, and these don't have the highest CRI value, but they're color accurate enough for YouTube videos and just for quick filming and stuff like this that even though they're only 90 CRI, I'm able to get away with them as backdrop lights. I'm not using them on skin or on people. So that's kind of why I'm using them here in the office, but I wouldn't use these for a more professional. But these work great for here in the office, and I have three of them that light up this backdrop. The two on the one on the left and the one on the right, those are new. I just added those this week, which is another reason I kind of wanted to do this video. I was adding a couple small things to the office, more on that in a second. But I have three up top, and then we have our one light right here. All of these are the larger Singled smart bulbs. They work with a little Singled hub. This hub connects to all the different lights, and then I can actually turn them on and off with my Google Smart Hub, which is I believe the Google Nest Hub Mini. This guy actually allows me to control all the lighting. I can dim it, I can change the colors, and I can do that by voice, or I can actually swipe the screen, can go over to the lighting controls and control all the lights right down here. Additionally, the Google Nest Home Hub Mini, whatever it's called, I can also pull up my security cameras for down here in the office. There's a lot of expensive gear and stuff like that down here. I have some security cameras down here in the office, as well as security cameras around the house, so that I'm not having to get up from my desk to see what's going on around the house when, you know, the doorbell rings or the dogs are barking. I can see exactly what's going on in the front yard, in the backyard, and around the house from right here, and I don't have to get up and be distracted from what's going on. If it's just the Amazon guy at the door, there is no reason to get up and grab that package right now. Let's go get it when we're taking a break. So the Google Home Hub Mini is extremely clutch to have on the desk. You can use it for a ton of different things. Music, you can use it for the security cameras, you can use it for your lighting. There's tons of different things you can do with it, as well as it giving you notifications, even reminders to get up and, you know, stretch throughout the day. So it's pretty damn functional, and I absolutely love having that thing on my desk. Not only is it an awesome looking clock, but it is extremely functional for just keeping you at your desk and productive throughout the day. Moving on from all of our lights and everything is our actual custom built PC. This is the first custom built PC I ever built. This is the first one that I built absolutely from scratch. So I'm pretty proud of this PC, and it is a beast at handling all all of the photo editing that I currently need it to do. It handles all of the footage that I need it to be editing at this time, and it exports extremely quickly. So I have absolutely no issues with this PC. Just to go over the specs with you guys really quickly on this actually kind of budget PC, but it's like I said, it's extremely efficient. This is a Ryzen 3800X with 32 gigabytes of RAM. I am thinking about upgrading the RAM to 64 gigabytes soon. I have two M.2 drives in there. One runs the operating system. The other one is actually a scratch drive that I use for Premiere Pro. This just speeds up my workflow in Premiere Pro, being a PC editor. I have a 500 gigabyte drive that I, 500 gigabyte SSD drive that I just use for, you know, quick projects and stuff that I want to edit really quickly. Two 4 terabyte hard drives in a RAID configuration. Both of those hard drives, you know, if one goes out, the other one is an exact copy. So it's that's the one that I use for all of my client files and important files before they're archived, which for all of my archival purposes, I use Google Drive. Google Drive, it's only 12 bucks a month or something like that for a Google Business account. With Google Business account, you get a unlimited Google Drive storage. So as much stuff as you want to toss up there, you can. So as soon as I'm done shooting, I archive all of my footage in Google Drive. That way I don't need to have a NAS storage at this current time. I don't need to have 30 hard drives sitting over to the side with all my archive footage. It's a lot cheaper to just use Google Drive to archive all my footage, even over a lifetime of saving all of this footage. It's way cheaper to do it that way than it is to continually buy hard drives, at least at this current point in time. So that is my workflow for storage. In this computer, there is a very simple graphics card, but it is actually extremely efficient at editing, and I don't currently feel the need to upgrade to a better graphics card, and that's the GeForce 1660. It's not the Ti or anything like that. It's just this 1660, and it actually is an extremely good graphics card for Premiere Pro and for video editing, and I don't feel like I need to upgrade my graphics card at this current time with the footage that I currently edit. All of these components are sitting on a X570 gaming edge motherboard with Wi-Fi. The only reason I got this motherboard was it was a good price, and it was expandable for adding future hard drives. It could handle everything that I wanted to put onto it. So that's the reason I got that motherboard. And it was also gonna be good for future upgrades. All of those components are inside of an NZX H510, an extremely common case. I don't think you guys need to spend a ton of money on your custom PC case. It's not something that's gonna drastically increase the performance of your PC, especially if you guys are doing a typical fan cooled build. Unless you guys are going water cooled, you probably don't need to spend a lot of money on your case. Moving on from there, from the actual custom PC, we have all of our peripherals. Now, the two monitors that I'm using, I get asked about all the time. These are both extremely simple monitors. One of them is an LG ultra-wide monitor. It's the 34-inch IPS LED FreeSync monitor with HDR. My God, that is a mouthful, but that's the monitor that I'm using for my main monitor. And then off to the side, the vertical monitor that I'm using is actually just a Samsung 32-inch TV that I just threw up there vertically. It has the Visa mount on the back of it, and the monitor mount that I'm using is just a dual monitor mount by Mount It. I'm able to get away with just a $60 dual monitor mount It worked phenomenal. Moving on from the monitors themselves, I went ahead and got some nice leather desk pads. These work phenomenal for the mouse. I don't notice anything on the mouse. The mouse is still super responsive and, you know, works perfectly fine on top of this surface. And it just feels really, really nice. Gives a really little bit of protection to the desk, and it adds like a nice contrast for when I actually have products and want to do stuff like that on top of the desk. Another huge reason that I went with white, it'll actually bounce any light that I have back onto my face. That way I don't need such a powerful light, and I can use a little bit of that bounce light to help light the underside of my chin. So I can definitely recommend these desk pads. I think they're under $20 on Amazon. They're one of the cheapest desk pads that you guys can get, and they come in tons and tons of different colors. So whether you guys have, like, you know, different stain of wood than this ebony kind of look, you guys could go with any color that's gonna look good with your guys's desk. I went ahead and got the white ones. Sitting on top of the desk pad right behind me is the Logitech Craft keyboard. This is actually an older keyboard now. This is the best keyboard I have ever owned in my entire life. It was very expensive, probably spent more money on this thing than I should have, but it is extremely functional. It works for three different devices. I have it hooked up to my iPad, I have it hooked up to my computer, and I have it hooked up to my Chromebook that sits right over there. That way, whatever device I'm using or working on at that time, I can actually just, you know, hit the 1, 2, or 3 and it switches right over to that device, and I can start typing, and then I can switch back to my PC when I want to type on my PC. Another thing that's super nice about this keyboard itself is the fact that it has that nice little jog wheel up there in the top left corner. That works for whatever program. You can actually customize that to work for whatever function you guys want it to work for. So for me, in Premiere Pro, I have it work to work for the left and right scroll in my timeline. So yeah, that's super nice to have, and just speeds up your workflow a little bit. But your mouse, the mouse that I'm using is actually the Logitech MX Master 3. This mouse is phenomenal. I have never owned a mouse like this either. Logitech makes some phenomenal peripherals. However you say it. Logitech makes some phenomenal ones. I have never ever had my wrist bother me using this mouse. With my old mouse, after like 2 hours of using that thing, editing or doing something on the computer, your wrist would literally just start to bother you. I think this mouse is like $100. That's the most money I've ever spent on a mouse, and it was well worth it. It has all sorts of quick functions to do, you know, stuff on your PC or on your Mac. It has these forwards and backwards buttons right here. It has the scroll wheel right here. This scroll wheel on top actually has two different modes. So it has a free spin mode, and then it has the mode with the click. So depending on what you want for what you're doing, you can either switch it to the free spin, or you could switch it to the click, which is extremely nice. Additionally, just like the keyboard, you can switch it to switch it between three different devices. This does work on your iPad. It works on my Chromebook. It works on my Samsung laptop, which my dad actually has out in Wyoming with him for a live stream right now, along with the ZV-1. So we're filming on the A7C today. But those are the keyboard and mouse that I'm currently using, and they're by far well worth the investment. If you guys don't want to get the Craft keyboard, I can highly recommend that new Logitech MX Master keyboard. I'll link to it right below the craft keyboard, but I would recommend getting that over the craft keyboard because the only thing that's missing is that dial. And with if you guys get the mouse, you don't really need the dial on the keyboard because you already have those functions, or you can have those functions on the mouse. So you don't need to have like double functions. SD card reader that I'm using, which I'm super proud to have, is the Sony CF Express Type A card reader. It is so fast. I mean like 300 megabytes per second fast. It is so fast. It is ridiculous. I can literally transfer a whole entire card in like 2 minutes. So I thought that was extremely impressive the first time I did it, and now I just always want to shoot at my CF Express Type A card because the speed to get that thing onto the computer and start editing is ridiculously quick. Moving on from the card reader, the headphones that I'm using are just the Sony WH-XB900Ns. And these are just the simple noise-canceling headphones from Sony. They're not the top-of-the-line ones, but they're the model under them. Damn, can I recommend these headphones. They are phenomenal headphones. They might even have a newer model to them out by now, but this model of headphones I absolutely love. The finish of the headphones is phenomenal. The way they fit is phenomenal. I love the noise canceling of them. It's the best noise canceling I've ever had on a set of headphones. I'm sure there's headphones out there that are better, but for price to performance, these are probably the best headphones that you guys can get. Whether you guys are editing, whether you guys are at the gym listening to music, or you guys are just out and about and need something to listen or monitor to something with, these headphones are awesome. They look great, and they're Sony, so they're pretty much the all-around perfect headphone, and they're a little bit cheaper than those top-of-the-line. I think they're the 1000 model headphones from Sony. These are the headphones to get, in my opinion. If they have a newer version out, go ahead and get those ones. But these headphones at the time, I thought they were the best headphones to get, which is why I got them. The external hard drives that I use are just the Samsung T5s and the SanDisk Extreme SSDs. Both of these SSDs are very, very fast and fit all of my needs for data, quick storage, and even to use for editing in Premiere Pro. And all of that brings us to our iPad. Now, my iPad, I typically have sitting right over to my left. I use my iPad is just my daily planner. I use it to take notes. I use it as my calendar. I use it as my sketchbook. I use it to edit photos that I want to share with friends, family, and even the occasional Instagram post, which I definitely need to do a lot more of. But I use my iPad for as much stuff as possible these days. Being a full-time dad, a full-time content creator, and owning multiple businesses, and I'm trying to hire my first employee right now, being able to work mobily is extremely, extremely important. So even if I have 5-10 minutes at the park while my daughter's playing with her friends, it's definitely extremely valuable time. The iPad has been phenomenal for being able to just stay on top of my workflow throughout the day, even if I'm not down here in the office. Additionally, one other thing that I have on top of my desk, as you guys can see, I don't have monitoring speakers here in my home office yet. When I do need to listen to music and stuff like that, I'm usually doing other stuff like organizing the office or something like that. When I'm editing, I typically have on headphones. Again, full-time dad, I need headphones, noise canceling, all that kind of stuff when I'm editing. So that's why I use headphones over monitoring speakers. I don't want to hear any of the ambient noise in my house. I just want to hear my edit. That's why I don't have actual monitoring headphones. When I am just listening to music or something on YouTube or whatever the case may be, I use my Sony Bluetooth speaker. I also use that for photo shoots, just to kind of give the photo shoot a little bit of a vibe, not to make it so boring and stale. I'd love bringing a Bluetooth speaker with me just to kind of set the mood and, you know, liven things up a little bit. Bluetooth speaker is definitely something to have in your office, which that brings me to our go bag. The go bag that I am currently using is the Peak Design 6-liter go bag. Peak Design 6-liter sling. This bag has been awesome since I got it. I don't know why I put it back down there. Let me grab it. Bag has been awesome. Ever since I got my Sony ZV-1, I was looking for some kind of small bag solution, some small quality bag that looks good for meetings and stuff like that. I can wear it not only with a suit, but I can also wear it just with my normal attire. And that was this Peak Design bag. I think every home office, you guys are gonna need a go bag because you're gonna be outside of the office for probably over 50% of your work. Really, the only time I'm here in the office working is when I'm editing, when I'm have scheduled stuff that I'm doing in the office that I need to get done. Outside of that, I'm typically working from my iPad and trying to get things done on the go. So on the go, you're definitely gonna need some kind of hard drive. Again, here's another one of those SanDisk SSDs. This one I always have in my bag. That way, if I need to grab files from any of my peers, any of the people that I work with, or I need to hand off some of my files, I can definitely do that. And they can either mail this back to me or, whatever we need to do, we can figure it out later. But with that in my bag, I have options. Additionally, inside of my bag, I always carry an ND filter for my main on-the-go camera, my Sony A7C. My dad currently has my ZV-1 out in Wyoming for a fan or class reunion. I think it's his 50. Might be like a 70 year. No, I think it's this 50 year class reunion. But he has my ZV-1, my entire live streaming setup. I let him borrow a whole bunch of stuff. We went over how to use it and all sorts of stuff. So that was pretty fun. Some other stuff that I have in here. I just have marketing materials. I have my press pass. I cannot stress how important it is to have a press pass. This press pass will get you guys into the door of places you might normally not get into without a press pass. This press pass has gotten me out of trouble with police. This press pass has really done a lot for me. So if you guys have never checked out Make Art Now or Josh's video on how to make a press pass, I'm definitely gonna link to that video down below so that you guys can make yourself one of these press passes, and maybe I'll show you guys how I designed mine. I'm probably gonna redesign this now that I've been using Canva so much lately. Definitely design your guys selves a press pass. That will not only get you out of trouble, but it can also get you places with your camera that you might not have access to without being a journalist or a member of the press. So definitely get your guys selves a press pass. I definitely can recommend that. Outside of the press pass, a few things that I carry in here are marketing materials for all of my businesses. So right now I have stuff in here for Buzz Labs Creative, as well as my 360 tour business. Other than that, I have my full-size press badge, which this one I can just wear right around my neck. It's in a Think Tank press credential holder. That is a phenomenal press credential holder. If you guys like to do, press related stuff that you guys might need a press pass for, I can highly recommend the
think tank press pass credential holder.
Outside of that, inside of the go bag, we just have a towel, some other small stuff, some Zeiss cleaning pads. But yeah, go bag is extremely important in a home office because a lot of the work that you guys are going to be doing is at your clients' offices. It's going to be at your, you know, people that you're working at, places of business, especially when you guys are working with clients that are probably a lot more established than you guys are. That is all I had for today's video. You guys got to see the lights that I'm using. You guys got to see the desk surfaces that I'm using. You guys got to see all the peripherals down to the SD card. And you guys even got to lift up the skirt on my custom PC. So I think that's all I have for today's video. So I am going to leave you guys with that for today, but I will see you in the next video. Peace. Aw, man. I forgot to tell him about the blue light glasses. We'll have to save it for the full office tour.